2.6 billion, that's the estimated number of people around the world that is still without access to the internet. That's a third of the global population. The UN's International Telecommunication Union said the number of people connected to the internet is on a record high, which means connectivity efforts are going in the right direction. It adds it won't rest until everyone everywhere has access to the internet.
The Asian Development Bank approves a $303 million loan to boost flood resilience in the Philippines. The loan will fund the construction of flood protection infrastructure in three major river basins. It will also go to capacity building for government officials and equipment for weather and river flow monitoring. The project is pursuant to the Marcos administration's climate priorities and the Philippine Development Plan.
Vladimir Putin hosts North Korea's elusive leader for a summit in Russia's Far East. Putin and Kim Jong-un held talks Wednesday at the Russian Aerospace Center in Vostochny. There, Kim reaffirmed Pyongyang's support for Moscow in their supposed fight against imperialism. Western countries are closely watching the meeting as they suspect the two would agree on a deal for arms trade and defense technology. Back in Pyongyang, North Korea's military launched two short-range ballistic missiles into the sea off its east coast. Both South Korea and Japan condemned the latest missile launch.
A geopolitical analyst not ruling out the possibility of an arms deal being forged during the visit of Kim Jong-un to Russia. International Studies professor Don McLean Hill says the timing of Kim's trip casts doubt on the two countries' assertion no such agreement would take place.
Comes at a time when the Russia-Ukraine war is currently facing a strategic stalemate. You know, it is interesting that along with North Korean foreign minister, North Korean leader Kim Jong-un is also accompanied by a senior military official and, of course, a munition point of a potential arms trade and tech transfer deal between the two countries is seen to be a possibility. You know, perhaps one can assume that there could be a deal given that North Korea has a vast supply of artillery shells in exchange for Russian technology for advanced weapons.
Four entities have shown interest in bidding for the Ninoy Aquino International Airport Rehabilitation Project. We have more from Andrea Taguines.
Transportation Assistant Secretary Lionel De Velez told ABS-CBN News that the Manila International Airport Consortium, San Miguel Corporation, the India-based GMR, and one more entity have all purchased bidding documents for a chance to secure the 170.6 billion peso contract to rehabilitate the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. Earlier this year, the Manila International Airport Consortium, composed of six Philippine conglomerates and its U.S.-based partner, also made an unsolicited proposal to rehabilitate NAIA under a 25-year contract. But the government opted for a solicited deal with a concession period of 15 years with a possible 10-year extension anchored on performance. The Public-Private Partnership Center opened the bidding process last August 23. Develas said they aim to award the contract by this year, as he stressed the need to fix the country's main gateway as soon as possible. According to the PPPC, both foreign and local parties are invited to bid for the contract to rehabilitate, operate, optimize, and maintain NAIA. The project will cover all facilities of the airport, including its runways, four terminals, and associated facilities. It aims to increase the current annual airport capacity from 35 million to at least 62 million passengers, as well as increase air traffic movements from 40 to 48 per hour. Dubbed as one of the worst airports in the world, NAIA often sees passenger congestion and has seen at least three major power outages this year. Develas also said that developing NAIA and other international airports in the Philippines is key to boosting tourism. He cited Malaysia, Thailand, Vietnam, and how they are all investing in their airport infrastructure. So he said the Philippines needs to do so as well to remain competitive and to bring in more tourists.
So far, there was the previously the consortium, that the Manila International Airport Consortium, that's number one. there was San Miguel Corporation also purchased the bidding documents, and GMR. And the fourth one, I have to confirm which one, because I just got the information on yesterday. Target is really have something this year, because as we know, we need to upgrade and rehabilitate the EA as soon as possible.
In the meantime, ASEC Develez assured stakeholders at the summit that they are undertaking measures to ensure that there will no longer be power outages in NAIA.
The state's Information Technology Department proposes the issuance of digital national IDs to address the slow rollout of physical cards. If approved, DICT Chief Ivan Uy says the digital IDs can be released by the end of the year. Uy explains the DICT will need access to the biometrics and personal data collected for the national ID program. Last December, President Marcos ordered the PSA to fast-track the printing of the national ID cards.
So for us to be able to convert it to a digital format, we needed access to that database so that we can deploy it on a digital platform. So that was the discussion, and that was where we reported to the president as to how we are going to adopt it on a digital platform, and so that it can eventually be used for all our online transactions.